today is going to be another does it work on dark hair video. If you guys are new to my channel, my name is Teresa Harada. I have a series here on YouTube where I try dyes, chalk, sprays, all on my really dark, unbleached hair to see if it leaves a color, a tint, anything. Obviously, these products work a lot better on bleached or lightened hair, but this is just a fun experiment. So today, going along with the whole Halloween theme, if you guys watched my haul, you saw I had picked these up at Target. I know my last video was also a spray, but I really wanted to do a video on these because they're everywhere. If you go to a Target, you've seen these. So I thought this would be helpful for you guys if you were looking in Target and thought about picking these up but were unsure. So we are going to try the Target Color Hairspray. Oh, it's a very upfront name. I got it in two colors and we're just gonna have fun and spray it all over my hair, see how it works, if it comes off, what kind of color it gives, all that. So if you guys are interested in seeing how these work on my hair, then keep watching. So I did get two colors. I got white and orange. I had never tried a white before, so I'm very excited. And then orange just seems like a really cool Halloween color. It doesn't look like there's any kind of, okay, Ruby's Costume Company, I think might be the brand name. There was a ton of colors in Target, and these only cost $2 each. So if they actually work, it's gonna be a really, really good deal. I'm gonna open this. It says to shake well before each use, so I will do that. The instructions, protect clothes from overspray. From all my times doing this, protect your floor as well. You might not see it, it's there. Shake well and spray evenly in short bursts from about 10 inches. Avoid dwelling on one place. There's nothing wrong with that sentence, yet it made me laugh because it just sounds like my grandma. Avoid dwelling on one place. Actually very good life advice. This is a temporary hairspray which will shampoo out. Avoid face and eyes. Could cause irritation. Do not use on dyed, permed, or light blonde hair. It says it may stain that hair, so keep that in mind. I guess we always complain about our dark hair, nothing showing up, but we have an up on the lighter hair today. Let's shake these really good. This shirt again was gladly donated from Bruce. I think I'm just gonna do half and half because obviously this part of my hair is kind of styled in this little poof thing. I'll do just like half orange and half white. Like the regular spray mechanism, 10 inches away. Since I'm trying to get like right up here, I'm gonna just use like a thing, even though then I can't see. I definitely breathed dead in a little bit. I can see a tiny tint. I really didn't do too much. I just wanted to like get a feel. Ooh, there we go. I see it. I'm pretty sure I can't, do I see it? Yeah, it's using a well-ventilated area. Very well ventilated. It would make sense, right, with these kind of things to use in a well ventilated area. I've never had that issue with any other sprays that I've used. Whew. I might have to turn the air on. I hope you guys don't mind. All right, guys, I apologize for the noise. I'm actually feeling a slightly bit lightheaded right now, so let's continue. I just realized my nails are getting like covered in. It's actually giving an interesting, cool look. It's kind of like a gradient. Hopefully this washes off. I'm trying to take short breaths. I forgot about the short burst part. I was doing kind of long sweeps, so maybe that's why I'm I think that's pretty good. Like, that's actually looking very pigmented or like colorful. So we're gonna do the bottom here then really quick. So it's definitely taking a lot longer when I'm doing short spurts, so I'm tempted to just not breathe again and just do it. I feel like I'm getting a little bit of what happened in my last video where I'm spraying it a lot and it's saturating the hair, so it's not showing up as evenly, probably because I'm kind of going hardcore on it. So we're gonna let this side dry and move on to the white. My past experience when it dries, it's very vivid. So here's the white. I think I know what it is that's doing it, and now I recognize the scent. It smells like acetone, which is a ingredient here that was not in the other ones that I tried, I don't think. So that's why. I definitely smell like that right now. Do this outside. So you can see this looks amazing. Like, it's very vivid. So we're gonna try the bottom now. How's this guy doing? This is drying. Okay, guys, so this is what we have right now. It looks good. The fumes are getting to me a bit. I swear, they look good. So if I'm gonna be like super critical here, again, these are $2, so we can't be that critical. This one looks much more realistic than this. The look that these give is a very stringy effect, which I think works really well with white. I feel like it definitely has that kind of older look. The orange looks very like neon, and in person you can see like each individual strand orange, and then like my hair underneath, because obviously I can't reach the hair underneath with the spray because my hair's already pulled up. There's the bottom of this, but obviously there's so much more to spray because my hair keeps on moving, so you're not gonna get as vivid of a top as unless I like really get in all the strands. Then this is the white one, which actually did really, really good. Better than I think the orange on just my straight hair. But I also think the issue with the orange is that once I realized I was doing it wrong, where I wasn't doing short spurts, I was doing long spurts, I switched and it actually worked worse. And much better results doing long sweeping motions. Although I can hardly breathe in here, do not do this indoors. I would say if it has acetone in it, do it outside. Not only because you can't really breathe when you're doing it, but because the fumes off your head are also going to need to be dispersed by some fresh air. Right now, I was walking out to the other room to try and get away from it in this room, and it was following me because it's on my hair. So now I'm gonna wash my hands, see how easy that is to do, and then we'll come back and do the paper towel test. Okay, so it's been about, I would say, 7 minutes since I put this on. It doesn't say you have to wait for it to technically dry. We're just gonna go ahead and test it right now. I will also mention that acetone and alcohol, both of which are in this, are a little bit drying on the hair. It's only one day, so it shouldn't really make a difference, but just an FYI. So I'm gonna take a white paper towel, and we're gonna do the, well, okay. I don't know how to test this one. Oh, maybe I should use a black t-shirt. I'll ask Bruce for a black t-shirt. I'll do this one, so pat, and a rub. Okay, there's a little bit. You guys can see that. Take a clean one, just do it once more. Pat, rub. So that one's a little heavier of a rub, so there's definitely some transfer. And just a long rub here. Yeah, there's definitely transfer. To be expected, very inexpensive spray. I have a black t-shirt here. I'm just gonna be using like this part, which is, there's like a tiny bit of fuzzy, but it's nothing crazy, so. I'm gonna do pat, and a rub. Definitely some. The good thing about white though is, I mean, does it actually really matter? I mean, yes, on black clothing, but other than that. So then let's do it at the bottom. Fresh peach. Just kind of looks like deodorant stains, to be honest. Oh, I got some in my mouth and it tastes so bad. How did I do that? 5 minutes after the fact. I need to get out of this room. If you guys watch my other color spray videos, I always try the hairspray test. I wasn't gonna do it today, but I figured might as well in case this is the only video that you see. I will give it a try, but usually it does not work. The theory behind this is that it'll lock it in so that there is no transfer, so let's give it a go. Oh. Gonna rub. It definitely helped a little bit, but there's still transfer. So final thoughts on the Target color hairspray. $2 each, I would say go for it. I think that these are absolutely amazing. They do what they're supposed to do. This is pretty much for a night. You're paying $2 for like a one-time use if you wanna spray your whole head. Probably if I was gonna do my whole head orange, I would need a couple bottles. The white was so, so good. I actually wish I had an outfit to go along with that, that I could pretend I have like gray hair because it looks so good. And the white, genius. You're not gonna be worried about getting white on anything unless it's a really dark outfit. But even then, I feel like that's not the biggest deal because it's going to wash off. It did say that these could potentially stain fabric, but I guess that would just depend on the type of fabric that you're wearing. But I do really like those. Yes, they have transfer, absolutely. The way my hair feels right now is super, super stiff. It is very stringy feeling. So yes, you cannot play with your hair, you can't like touch it or anything, but for $2, I would say it's a fun spray. I have a bunch of different colors if you wanna try those. Definitely do it outside. I'll have a washout update in the description box so I can let you guys know how this washed out. It's supposed to wash out very easily in one shampoo, so I will let you guys know that. And definitely leave me any questions you have down below, and thank you so much for watching this video. Let me know any other ideas you have for any other videos you want me to do, and just opening our DoorDash back there. So I'm gonna go and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.